What's up guys, thank you for watching. So before we actually get to the part where we can see if we can install these cages in 10 minutes, we wanna talk about why we're doing this video. So the quick release version of our cages is something we offer for all four-door sedan cars, especially now with our G80 M3 and a lot of newer models coming out in sedan form. We wanna show you guys what everyone's been asking about, what the quick release system does. And basically it allows you to take your cage in and out of the car within 10 to 15 minutes. We've got Cody here. He's gonna do Juan's car in the background, and then later on I'm gonna do our own Project Senna's reinstall. So this cage has obviously been in the car before. We've taken it in and out a few times. So now I wanna put it back in because I'm done driving around with my baby in the back. So
practical.
Yeah.
Being able to take it out.
So we're gonna do a little bit of cheating, but I guess you guys at home could do the same, is like have everything ready, right?
Yeah.
So stay ready is our motto. So. You wanna talk about what tools we're gonna be using?
Sure. So for the actual cage installation, we have two 17 millimeter nuts, bolts, two 13 mils with four washers, and then a total of 8 cap screws or hex screws, bolts.
Socket head cap screws.
Socket head cap bolts.
SHCS.
Yep. these are actually 6 millimeter. And then all of the tools that we will be using, we use an impact for
Cheater.
These. That's why I have the ratchet out in case people don't have power tools. So 13 millimeter wrench, 13 millimeter socket, 17 millimeter socket. We use a stubby 6 millimeter Allen. It's just easier to get to the access to the bolts that hold the main to the rear section. And then you obviously need a leaf blower.
So depending on how sick your car is, definitely have a leaf blower. You know, because if your car's fire, you're gonna wanna put it out.
All right,
serious again. So before, to make this as fair as possible, because Cody's a crazy tech, that's why he works on the cars, we're gonna obviously take Juan's cage back out. So again, we're gonna show you a little bit of how quickly Cody can take one out that's already in, and then he'll show you the standard parts of the installation as he's doing it. When you guys first get your cage, you know, obviously it's gonna take around 2 to 3 hours for the initial install, but once the system's in there and the cage is in there, then swapping it in and out is like 10 minutes. All right, we're gonna time you on this one. I didn't tell you that, but we'll
just time you.
So real time. Should I put on a timer or a stopwatch, dude? Yeah. We should do a countdown. 10 minutes.
These guys are giving me 10 minutes, but I'm also going to be instructing you guys on how to actually get the cage out at the same time. Pretty confident.
Whoa.
I can still get it out in 10 minutes.
We've got a badass over here.
Oh, okay. Ready? Are you ready?
Sure.
You sure?
Yep.
Stay ready, dude. Go.
So we have the 6 millimeter bolts that we'll be taking out.
No pressure, but he has like the really nice carbon seats.
White interior, make sure you keep your hands clean. Moving to the back.
Ooh, he dropped something.
Oh no,
oh, he dropped
two
things.
It's gone forever. And then we have the quick connects or quick release portion of it.
I don't know if you guys are still watching, but if you are, we don't know what else to show you because we're just turning wrenches and bolts and stuff right now. And he's taking forever to do
it. Oh, whatever.
Yeah, whoever did this rap, huh, Mike? Who did this rap?
Who did this rap?
All All right, so
now your children have a nice little jungle gym.
Do we have a, is that time then?
Yes.
Time. Oh, sorry guys. Freak, I hit cancel instead of stop. It was 2 minutes and 3 seconds. So, all right, so how much longer do you think it would be to put the seat uprights back in?
Obviously. That's like 10 minutes, to be honest. That's like, well, it depends. I mean, make sure you keep your hardware organized, like 5 minutes.
Yeah, the bet was to get the cage out. So he did it, 2 minutes and 3 seconds. Dude, I think you could do it in 10 minutes because you have 2 minutes. We're but we won't do that. He's already, look at him, he's sweating like crazy.
It's hot.
Yeah. So we have to put this in because Juan's going to pick up the car in a little bit. So we'll leave the putting the seats back out of the video.
I don't know, dude.
Now I'm kind of getting nervous.
Where's the hardware at?
So we'll be right back. I'm going to go get my hardware and my tools ready. And then we're going to race to see who could do it faster.
You can have Dylan. I'll go get Robert. Or not, Richard. Makes it fair.
And we're back. So
3, 2, 1, go. No, I'm just kidding. I'm sorry. Love the head.
I forgot what I was going to say. All right, guys. We're back. So Cody got it out in under 8 minutes. I've got my tool set up. Hey, that's not fair, dude. Okay. Cody, are you ready?
No. I'm missing 2 cap screws.
The excuses.
I got them.
He's the one who took them out, so. It's already not fair because the tools and the stuff is farther from my car than it is his car.
Don't worry, I'll sandbag for you.
No.
I'm actually going to give you a 1 minute head start.
No, because you're just going to talk shit the whole time.
I'm going to give you a 1 minute head start.
Ready?
Wow, no power tools. That's a bold strategy. I'll let you use this guy.
I'm not nervous at all or anything. Yeah, it's just... Thank you, Leo. Crap. Hey, this seat's already rolled forward. That's not fair.
Oh. I'll wait. Waiting. Uno momento, por favor.
Wow, dude, you're that confident? You're that confident?
You're the one that's gonna need somebody to put the cage in.
Okay. I'm holding this up all by myself. Leo's hand is not doing anything. He's just there for moral support. So I lost pretty bad, but I'm glad about that. But I'm gonna finish my install real quick and be right back with you guys, so. Wow!
I didn't use an electric ratchet until the end too.
Okay.
I reversed it out.
Loser!
Sorry.
He's already doing another car. How disrespectful.
Darn, I'm sorry. I forgot to put that back in for you. Where did this come from?
Nice. You did it. Good job.
Thanks, dude. You too.
He didn't help me.
Didn't have any help at all. That was great. Not one bit. You did get the main in by yourself, so props to you on that one.
I'm holding this up all by myself. Leo's hand is not doing anything. Yeah. All right, guys. So what time did you time yourself? Because I went over 10 minutes for sure.
Probably about 10 or 11 minutes.
About 10, 11 minutes. It's a lot easier if you have a helping hand. We did it Both of us did it by ourselves, so it took a little bit longer.
I actually did it by myself.
So hope you guys see that is the quick release option that we guys offer. And also too, I think we noted in the beginning, or forgot to note in the beginning, that we can do these on coupe cars as well, but like the advantage of getting the cage in and out is that quick because we don't have to take any of the seats out. So on a coupe, you would have to take your seats out, or on some models like the JDM cars, you can slide them forward and have enough room to get the main hoop out. But I suggest for anyone with a four-door, definitely upgrade with the quick release option because you don't have to take your seats out. So before we wrap up the video, any suggestions, Cody?
For the main section, usually you just slide it right in. For these cars, because the two plates are on the end, we like to slide it in, get it pretty much seated fairly enough to get it engaged, and then pull it, and then it'll all function properly.
Cool.
Or it'll go in.
So the quick release option is, again, meant for people who are doing double duty for their car. So people who want to street drive their car, have the ability to take the cage out, and then have the ability to put it back in, go do a track day, time attack, or something like that. But if you're looking to do a bolt-in cage for NASA time trials or SCCA time trials, don't recommend really doing the quick release option. But again, this is how we like to build our cars. We like to drive our cars to the track and take them home. So quick release option, it works out well. If you guys have any questions, hit us up at StudioRSR on Instagram. Our website's www.studiorsr.com. And guys are ready to answer any questions. Hope to see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.